Steve Hunter.
All through my career, I've been mostly a sideman, and I've never really been in the front, you know, like doing sort of my own thing. And all these guys have all this incredible stage experience in that format. And I've had a chance to learn a lot from those guys. I mean, I just stand in the wings and I watch them. And I've learned a lot about what it's like to be in the front instead of standing behind, occasionally coming up front for a solo or something, but it's not the same. There's a different responsibility there. It's a little bit scary.
It's almost like being part of a sort of a, theatrical school or something. You're on call all night and there's no emphasis on your own set, really. You're there for the whole show. It's like being part of a play or something.
The favorite thing to do on the show?
In the show.
Actually, it's ironic. It's one of Peter's songs. He's got a song called Lucienne.
Again, was from the Guitar and Son album. This one's called Lucienne. Yeah!
Thank you.
I'll see you later, all right?
It was Manny's Music Store in New York City. I was 14 years old. I walked into the shop, and he was standing there playing this Stratocaster. I asked if I could play the Stratocaster. He enjoyed the licks I was playing, and there was a spiritual communication between us, like we had known each other for a very long time. He invited me down to the club that night that he was playing. This was his first performance as a solo artist, and we played.
Was he calling himself Fear?
He called the band Jimmy James and the Blue Flames. We played together for 3 months, and the Animals, Chas Chandler came and wanted to take him to England to form the Experience. Jimmy asked me to go with him. Only being 14 years old, my mother and father said, no, you cannot go. It was a beautiful experience.
In my opinion, the greatest electric guitar player of all time, Jimi Hendrix, and he taught me this next song, so I want to dedicate this to him. Thank you.
I think my style was molded by the Doors in that we didn't have a bass player nor a rhythm guitar player, so I sort of had to play a little bit of everything. This here is the one I usually play. It's a 355. It looks like a 335, but it has a different binding. It's a heavier guitar, it's better sustained. This is a 1964 model, and that's my favorite guitar. What I'm gonna get them to do is put this neck on this guitar. That'll be the best of both worlds. What's that? Okay, what do you guys want to hear? I think we're gonna do one right now from the Guitar Speak album, which is called Guitar Speak. And the name of the song is Strut A Various. And it goes like this. Thank you.
you.
I mean, the twin lead guitar thing was something that was ready to happen at that point, early 70s. I mean, you'd had the blues boom of the late 60s, and there were a lot of good, fine players about. But, you know, we specifically wanted to do something to make our sound different. And we developed our twin lead guitar sound very carefully. I mean, there was nothing haphazard about it.
This man back here, he's a little bit of credit. He stepped into this experience not knowing what was going on. He learned everybody's songs in about 3 days. He's the hardest working man on the show. Mr. Clive Mayuyu. If you like this guy, give him a hand. There's a dear old friend of mine here. Miles, come out here. And we started in this business together 20 years ago. And come out here. Come on, Billy. This is the man you have to thank for this experience. He doesn't do this for the money, he does it for the love of music. Thank you, Miles. Okay, it's time for one of the old songs. We'll be right back.
I used to use a Les Paul Junior, and when I got it, it was so old, and after playing them, it sort of fell apart. I traded a couple, sold a couple, gave one to my mom. But right now I play Kramer and a Steinberg, and those two are pretty much my, they've got, after all the years, I finally narrowed it down to those two.
Are they off the shelf things, or did you hairy them up?
A couple of them are off the shelf. The Kramer, I put my own DiMarzio pickups in. Steinberg is right off the shelf.
We'll be right back.
Daniel. And you upstairs, too. Everybody downstairs, give the back of me the finger. I love you up there.
I combine a medley I pieced together of some Chet Atkins tunes. In fact, one of them's, I think, from Mel Travis, but just some American country tunes that I picked up. I can't remember all the titles, but there's Steel Guitar Rag. Oh, some horrendous titles. No, I can't think of too many of the titles right now, but things like In the Style of Steel Guitar Rag.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here this evening back in London. We've been the rounds, we've been around England. It's lovely to go back. I thought I'd play a few things that I picked up along the way from Chet Atkins, and then I wrote some, started writing some guitar music. Thank you.
fun to, because, you know, without not playing songs, you don't have to think of what you're talking about, you don't have to think of lyrical content and rhyming. You just play the music, and that's really what I've always liked to do.
Hey, now I'd like to do Otis Little. We'll be right back. Chris on the keyboards, Darren on the bass, Lyle on the drums, Leanne on the boys.
See, in my mind, the most important thing about this tour is not that nine great guitar players are on the same stage on the same night, but that we've formed a bond and a friendship, and we're working together as one unit, and we're supporting each other for the whole to be something greater than the sum parts.
It's every man's got their own way of using the guitar, you know, and that's what's so good about it.
It's amazing. We're all using the same amps, and nobody sounds like anybody else.
And the great thing about it is that everyone on the show has got their own individual style. They're all different. And, you know, it's, I suppose it's 1970s in origin, although a lot of the music I'm hearing on the tour has been very 80s, even 90s in terms of its...
The guitarists tend to be strange people, you know. You get bands working together and it's always the guitarist as the quiet guy stuck in the corner. And I was expecting it to be like that, but everybody was great, right from the word go. We've all had a great time.
Well, for me, more than the music, this tour has been about giving and sharing and us all sort of reaching for the same star. That's our common bond together. We're going to do a song now that you might recognize.
Thank you.
riders were approaching. Now let's listen to the riders as they approach on their horses. Across to Bradford. They're going up to Newcastle now. They're going up to Scotland. They're coming down to Liverpool. Coming over to Manchester.
Jared Roach, and I'm 15, and I come to see Randy California.
I'm coming from Switzerland, and I like all kind of guitar music, especially Alvin Lee.
I love Steve Howe.
Wishbone Ash.
Leslie West.
What's going on here?
There is more interest in the guitar, and that's why this tour came about.
It's never gone.
It's never gone. I mean, like, blues will never die.
We're not reviving anything. We're expressing the emotion of now, today. And that...
There's a future in it.
Hopefully it's a birth of something for great music to come.
Guitars!
What? See, that's the original case. It's a Black Beauty 55.
The Doors are the best band of all time.
They say rock and roll never die.
I missed the Roundhouse gig on 68 because I wasn't even born.
And rock and roll was going to be here forever.
Yeah. I missed the Isle of Wight Festival in 70 because I wasn't even born then.
With the Doors, it was the same age group, you know, that came to see us. And it's amazing. It seemed like it was just yesterday, you know.
It's born a few months after Morrison was supposed to have died. So I thought, see Robbie here. That's going to be mind-blowing enough.
Oh, it's sold out. I can't get a ticket.
The guitar reigns.
Good evening and
welcome to Night of the Guitar. Before we begin, I have an important health announcement to make. It seems that during the course of this tour, a number of our road crew and most of the audiences have been so stunned by what it is they have seen on stage that their mouths have locked in the open position and brain cells have been leaking from their ears. Ladies and gentlemen, to prepare you for what you are about to see, let me describe it this way. If you have entered this hall under the belief that there is but one God, you are about to find out, ladies and gentlemen, that that is simply not the case. There are, in fact, nine gods. Nine gods who can take a lump of wood and steel and make it speak in all known languages at the same time. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is not a concert. Tonight is a religious experience. Let me hear you say hallelujah. All right, to open the show tonight, originally in the Climax Blues Band, the man whose album was first on the No Speak series, Mr. Peter Haycock. Thank you.
Mr. Steve Hunter, all the way from Hollywood, California. We're going to do a song of Steve's on his new album, and this one's called The Idler. Thank you.
Right now, I'd like to introduce the man who's become our spiritual leader on this tour. Without him, I don't know whether we would have made it or not. He's really added a great deal to our, you know, our spiritual development. In fact, he was in a band not too long ago called Spirit. Would you welcome Randy California?
I came over from the States about a week ago. We've done an incredible tour all over England. And I gotta say, it was a great surprise when I got here and found these magnificent musicians to back me up and learn my new songs. Anyway, this song didn't have a title when I came over here, but Clive, our drummer, deemed it Groove Thing.
Wave of change.
Right now I have the great privilege to introduce to you a great guitar player from one of the greatest bands ever to grace the face of this planet. From the Doors, please welcome Robbie Krieger!
You guys don't want to hear anything by the Doors, would you? Okay, we're going to bring back Steve Hunter and Pete Haycock are going to come back for this one. I think you'll like it. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Canton on slide guitar.
Thank you. Okay, you guys, you're in for a treat. I want to introduce you. He's become a friend on this tour. That's all the guitarist now. But he's a big man, he's got a big guitar sound. Mr. Leslie West! What the hell is this? All week he's giving me these guitars without the head on. What am I gonna do with this? Sound bad though. You know, before I start, I wanted to first of all, Miles, why the hell did you have to make me follow them? Especially, I have no hair. Well, let me read this. Shut the hell up for a second. Let me read this, please. There's a lot of guitar players that came down tonight, but there's one in the audience that really taught me everything I know and is the defendant, Barry Manilow. Barry, you want to take a bow? Wait, what's the matter? This was written by Jack Bruce. I'm dedicating this to my partner Felix, who's up in heaven. It's called Theme for an Imaginary Western.
With laughter sound.
love you, Felix, wherever the hell you are. From Yes and Asia, my good friend Mr. Steve Howe.
We're going to play now the track I contributed to the Guitar Speak album for you now. It's called Sharp on Attack.
After your privilege, Alvin Lee.
Okay, now for change, I'd like to do an instrumental.
We'll be right back.
You want more? You want more? I can't tell you what an honor it has been to spend the last week with these guys. Ladies and gentlemen,
Mr. Alvin Lee!